Their best hope is the Missing Persons Bureau at Scotland Yard. Here, a team of civilians check descriptions of missing teenagers and adults against lists of people found dead or alive in twilight zones and on the capital's coldest streets. Their files are swollen by lists of people lost outside London and overseas. Their success rate?
Well, of those cases that we had recorded centrally in the Missing Persons Bureau last year, we found about 80% of them during the course of the year.
And what are your best clues to identity?
Well, the most long-lasting clue would be a dental record, because no matter what happens to the person, even if they die and are submerged in water or buried or something like that, the dental pattern remains longer than any other identification feature.
Is there any extra help that the family of missing people can give you?
Well, whenever somebody goes missing, the most important thing for them is to give us the most detailed description they possibly can. What they're wearing, any jewellery, marks and scars, any descriptive feature, because it all helps when it comes to identifying somebody.
Few provincial police forces can afford or need a full-time missing persons bureau. Filing cards at this one represent lost or forgotten loved ones who can't always be found alive. David Bellin at Scotland Yard.